The dumbbell press is one of two basic mass builders for shoulders. The other is a side raise. It's important that you work out shoulders because nothing looks sillier than a big, massive chest, huge arms, and then these little itty-bitty bony shoulders. Besides, strong shoulders are key for reducing injuries in everyday activities and in a lot of occupations. And let's not forget the superficial benefit. You can show off your big, broad shoulders even in a dress shirt. Too bad I don't own a dress shirt. The shoulder muscles are really small in comparison to other muscles like pecs or quads, so don't be expecting to use a lot of weight in this exercise. The shoulder is a complex joint and it's really easy to injure, so we're going to stress really good form in this video to keep you from getting injured. In this video, I'm going to show you two variations of the dumbbell press for shoulders. The first is the alternating variety, where we're going to lift one weight at a time while the other remains stationary. And this is the one we're going to start with. The second variation is where we're going to lift both simultaneously. You can do these either standing or seated, but if you do them seated in a chair, you cannot lean against the backrest, and we'll talk about why later. First, let's talk about the form we're going to use when we do these dumbbell presses. First of all, our entire torso is going to remain motionless except for our arms, which are moving. If you find you're moving back and forth or you're jumping up and down, you are cheating and you're going to get injured, so stop it. That's the reason I recommend doing these seated, because it's much harder to cheat. If you're standing, some people have a tendency to use their calves to jump up and down to get that last little bit, and you're just going to get injured doing that, so don't. Second point on form, when we're coming down, we are not going to go that far down. That's hard on the shoulder. We're going to stop when our arms are horizontal and go back up. So stop at horizontal when your elbow and shoulder are at the same height and go back up. Next point, good form, we're going to keep our palms away from us. So we're grabbing the dumbbells this way, keeping our palms away from us the whole time. Some people do a spinny little number with their hand, and it's easy to get carried away with that and torque your shoulder. So just keep your palms away from us. And while we're talking about this, no clanging the weights together, gong, gong, at the top. It's annoying as heck, and you're probably going to break the dumbbells and get a metal chip in your eye. So no clanking the weights. It doesn't do anything other than annoy people. Let's talk about the speed. It's really important that you do these slowly. We're going to try to do a count of two up. 1-1000, 2-1000, 1-1000, 2-1000. And we're going to hold it at the bottom too. What this does is it forces you to use good form. And if you can't use good form like this, drop the weight. It's okay. I don't care if you're doing 1 pound on these. It's better to do 1 pound with good form than to do 100 pounds with sloppy form. So we're going to do this slowly. 1-1000, 2-1000, 1-1000, 2-1000, hold. 1-1000, 2-1000, you get the idea. Okay, now the last and probably the most important point. We want to work out shoulders. We are not going to lean against the backrest. The reason is that what people do, they find that they can do more weight in this exercise if they lean against the backrest. And they kind of slouch down, and then they can do 2-3 times as much weight, and they're feeling really studly about themselves. But think about it. What are you doing? If you lean back and you're pushing up, you're doing an incline press for chest. You're working out completely your chest and ignoring your shoulder. And this is a shoulder exercise. We want to work on the shoulder, so no leaning against the backrest. We're going to either stand or we're going to be seated when we do these. Okay, that's it for form. Let's get started. Okay, here we go. Swing them up into position, starting position, hold. 1-1000, 2-1000, 1-1000, 2-1000, 1,000, 2,000. Notice my elbows are not going below my shoulders. I'm keeping this really slow. Two count up, two count down. And my back is not touching the backrest. There's no motion in my body other than my arms. And my quivering because I'm getting tired. And when you can't do any more good ones, stop. Don't push yourself on this. If you can't continue to use good form, stop. Make sure you master the alternating shoulder press before you move on to this exercise, which is the simultaneous one. The reason is the alternating press forces you to use good form, and we want to enforce those patterns of good form before we start this. So here's what the simultaneous one looks like. The trick on this, so 1,000, 2,000, 1,000, 2,000. The trick is to actually hold it right here. It's very tempting to just go, oh, oh, but we're not doing that, right? So we're holding 1,000, 2,000, 1,000, 2,000, hold. 1,000, 2,000, oh. And when you can't do any more, stop, don't push it. Let's talk about how often to do these dumbbell press exercises. If you're a beginner, I would say you should not be doing these at all. I would stick to more basic exercises like push-ups, pull-ups, and crunches if you're a beginner. If you're intermediate or advanced, then I would do these shoulder presses once a week as a part of your shoulder workout. And shoulder workout should be 45 minutes to an hour long once a week, and you should not work it out with any other body part. So a good portion of your workout would be pressing exercises that we just covered, some side raises, and assorted other exercises. You can check out my shoulder playlist to see all those other exercises. So that's it. Have fun working shoulders and fill out those dress shirts.
And now, for America's least favorite game show,
Pumper Stumper,
with your host, Hans the Bodybuilding Gnome.
Thank you, thank you, you're too kind, you're too kind. In this game show, we will test how much you learned in this video. All you have to do is determine if each of these five clips exhibits good form or bad form. Here we go. Okay, is this good form or bad form? He's doing jumping jacks. Next clip. Good form or bad form? He's exercising chest, not shoulders. Next clip. He's going way too fast. Next clip. What a doofus. Those aren't symbols. Next clip. He's twirling batons.